is the rarest thing in the world. Most people exist, and that is all.
More than our minds. We are so much more than our bodies. We are so much more than our jobs. We are so much more than our wives. We are so much more than our careers. We are so much more than what they taught us to be. We're not educated, we were programmed. Programmed to think in a certain way so that we could all behave in a certain way so they could control us. So we end up with a whole civilization that is totally messed up, and that's a very polite word. What happened to us when we were going to school is that they produced a lot of left-brain prisons. A lot of information was pumped into us. Individuality and creativity was taken away from us. We're living in a mad, mad world, aren't we? Because we are designed in a world to be separate from one another. We are designed in a world to live in a world that we are separate from nature. We're separate from, it's so bad that we become separate from ourselves.
So we wake up in the mornings, we've got screens. During the day we're sitting with screens. And so we catch up and we're panting. We're almost panting through life.
You know, if you eat healthy and you do stuff natural, do you know that they call it alternative? How wacky is that? And if you're in flow or in harmony with nature, which is what we are, they say you woo. You can do it. Because you are divine. And the camera is an extension of your eye. And the eye is an extension of your heart, of your being, of your soul.
Tuning back into the beat of life. It doesn't come from out of a lens. The lens is connected to you. We've lost the magic of a photograph. We're trying so hard to get it right all the time. We need to get back to creativity. Nature is our best teacher. The more photographs you can get wrong and call your own, that's photography. That's excitement, that's enthusiasm, that's having passion for life.
It's about experiencing life through the lens.
Take you on a bit of my journey, sky meets land, an intuitive journey. Just in case you're wondering what kind of photographs this woman actually takes. And when you become fully aware, I've been doing photography for 30 years. It's not my hobby, it's my life. It's never ever separate from who I am.
Tune in to the beat of life. And until you actually experience that, yes, I spoke to the sheep. And don't you dare call me woo woo. We just don't know how to listen because we were not programmed that way.
Being part of the wave, it's more important for the experience. I think a lot of photographers go out and they don't experience anything. I see it, I feel it, and I shoot it. Or, I feel it, I see it, and I shoot it.
I never ever crop. Ever. I have never cropped an image in 35 years. One of my Zen photographs. It's where everything is almost holding its breath. Can you feel it? The wings, the tide, the wave, everything's like just before it comes down.
I brought out recently an incredible series of DVDs where it teaches you to start connecting. It's called Capturing What People Don't Talk About. Energy, emotion, and spirit. I can confidently say to you that this is the future of photography. This is where it's going.
The more you tune into yourself, the more you grow, and the more your photography will expand to a higher awareness.
Life is about oneness. If you can just understand the concept with the mind that we are everything. The beat of photography is the beat that is inside each of us, in our hearts. I want to thank you all for listening to me today. Thank you.